I haven't actually. I had a look at it from the balcony or the change room. It looks pretty much the same colour as the outfield, so just I'm not going to complain about that. But I haven't actually been down, so I don't know what it looks like or anything. Look, I think the conditions always are a little bit different here in Durban compared to Johannesburg. There's always a bit more bounce in Joburg. This wicket seems to have gotten a little bit slower and a little bit flatter over the years, and hopefully we can actually get a game because there's always a bit of rain around here in Durban. So yeah, we'll have to have our focus on because, you know, as we discussed in our team meeting this morning, we could go out there for 20 overs, I think, is the minimum you could play. I actually don't know, something like that. So, which will still constitute as a one-day international. So if there's a bit of rain around, we've got to be prepared to play in whatever we face. Yeah, look, it's massively important. I mean, we've got an opportunity to seal the series here, you know. So we'd like to do that. Unfortunately, we didn't quite pull through against Pakistan, and those little moments where we could have made better decisions kind of went against us. So hopefully we can pull it off again on Sunday and put in a good performance. I think the boys are all, you know, the batters are batting extremely well. And I think in some small way we've already given the Indians a taste of what the conditions are. You know, it's not India where the ball doesn't get higher than the stumps. They've got to score in different areas and it's not going to be that easy, and we're kind of used to it. So hopefully there's more of that coming on Sunday, and if we can do that, a similar performance to what we had the other night, we should be able to come through with a victory.
What do they have to do?
I'm really not going to give them any advice, that's for sure. I think they're doing fine. if you want to, you know, look at it, I think they probably, with the ball, they lack somebody that can really get pace up there. They've got the one guy that can bowl a little bit of wheels, but Ishan's sitting on the side. I think he's the one guy that can bowl over 140 Ks. And when you've got really good batters like Callis, Amla, the Cox in a good space right now, De Villiers, I think you need guys that can either spin the ball a mile or can bowl really quickly. And, you know, the Wanderers didn't offer the turn the other night that Ashwin and Jadeja could have got, but it did offer a little bit of something off the deck and a bit of pace. And I think they didn't have that the other night, whereas we did. So we kind of blew them away with that. Mornay bowled really quickly. Ryan McLaren bowled with good pace and good areas, backed up by Wayne, myself, and Lopsy. So, you know, if you don't have that, you're going to be struggling in South Africa. Yeah, we've addressed that, actually. It's been a bit of a problem. Since we got back from Dubai, we just haven't been on the button. I think when we were in UAE, we were fantastic. I didn't think I stand to be corrected, but I don't think it got more than 10 in some of the games, you know. Wide's been a bit of a problem. I think the short ball we've struggled with, we really had to bang it in the UAE to get it up. And I think if you've been watching the last couple of games, a lot of wides have gone for 5, you know. They've gone right over the keeper. We just haven't hit the right length. I think that's purely because we don't want to hurt our batters in the net, so we don't really practice it. Those guys are going to harden up, though, because that's coming their way. But, yeah, it's something we're addressing. The other thing is that, you know, on Friday, when do we play? Wednesday. Sorry, today's whatever it is. Sorry. But, the other day we had a whole bunch of seamers and we didn't have a spinner. So, you know, if you're bowling a lot of wides, you're putting your captain under pressure too, because you tend to fall behind the over rate and you've got to make up that time. So we understand the importance of not making those mistakes again, because if that happens, we could get our captain banned, and we don't want that. I'd say so. I'd definitely say so. You know, I don't see many of our guys walking off the field with bloody fingers or, you know, ice packs on the ribs and stuff like that. So it definitely was a wake-up call for the Indians, I think. It's like I said earlier, it's not Mumbai where the ball doesn't get higher than the stumps. It's going to be hard to play here, but they're a good side. Look, they're not the number one ODI side in the world for no reason. And as MS said in his pre-match, they tour the world. They've come to South Africa a couple of times. So, you know, maybe give them a week or two, one or two more games, and they'll start getting used to it before the test matches. But definitely an eye-opener for them, because it didn't look that way when they were bowling to us, and it seemed to do all sorts of things when we were bowling. I can't remember what happened against Pakistan, to be honest with you. But look, the Wanderers wicket definitely offered a bit of bounce and a bit of carry and a lot of pace. I felt like we definitely try and do that against every team that comes to South Africa. We tried against Pakistan. The one game at the Wanderers was rained off, was it? Was it 2020? When did we play against Pakistan? 2020? So that was one quick wicket. Then you play in PE, there wasn't a lot of pace and bounce there. And Cape Town's not really known for a lot of pace and bounce, but there's a bit of bounce, so not a lot, though. So the Wanderers is the one place where you can really inflict, I guess, a bit of pain when as a fast bowling unit. I think we did that last night or the other day. I don't even know when it was, sorry. But, you know, we were able to do that because we got a full game in at the Wanderers. When you're able to get a full game at the Wanderers, under the lights, under those conditions, it can be kind of scary. Oh, I don't know, man. Look, I think that's what we try and do all the time when we bowl. Like I said, we're going to do that to any team that comes to South Africa, not just India. So, no, not really. Yeah, we haven't really had our deep, meaningful team meeting yet. We'll go through it, you know. Guys that have. Yeah, I think it's obviously, I'll use the old cliches, it's always going to do a little bit up front with the new ball, blah, blah, blah. But it's a harder working wicket, yeah. There's not as much pace. The funny thing is that you don't score big totals here either. I think the last time we played here, we played against Pakistan, and it wasn't a big total. It gets harder to bat at the back end of the innings. So for our batters, it might have to adapt a lot quicker. It's not going to be as easy as it was to score at the Wanderers the other night. From a bowling point of view, I think we always just want to hit hard lengths against a team like India, make them come at us, and hopefully with that little bit of bounce that South Africa offers, not just Kingsmead, but the South African pitchers, we might be able to just, you know, find the edge, and hopefully there'll be a bit of swing too, because it doesn't look like this weather's going to go away. Look, there's all the Indian players. Played them enough times internationally and played enough against them in the IPL to know that these guys can all perform on their day. I think Rohit scored 200 just the other day, you know, so even though he couldn't lay bat on ball the other night on those conditions, he's still a very good player, you know. MS showed how good he is in scoring runs. Virat Kohli, he can bat. I know him well, he's a good friend of mine, he can bat. So, you know, all of the Indians can perform. I just think our intensity the other night really blew them away, and I think we also showed that there was a slight weakness in their middle order. It looked like a couple of the guys, Rayner, Ashwin, you know, the latter batters too, they didn't really look like they wanted to get in the line. So hopefully we can exploit that a little bit more. But there's some batters out there that can really show how good they are. Shikha's another guy that can really bat. So we're prepared for that too. Everyone's a target, eh? To be honest with you. I think so, yeah. What is it? Vernon's fit. Vernon's fit again. He's fine. What else did you tell me on the way here? Imran is 50-50, as the lady over here says. But I saw he was running out there, so Emmy's also known for a miraculous recovery, so you never know with Emmy. So hopefully everyone will be fit and firing. But I think with the team that we've got, I think anybody is capable of playing at any time.